Blackstone presents 100 Turning Points in American History by Alan Axelrod. This book is read by Richard Ferrone. Introduction. Arnold J. Toynbee, the 20th century's most famous professional historian, is widely quoted as having declared, "History is just one damn thing after another." Well, the fact is that what he really did was to repeat another saying. Life is just one damn thing after another. But inasmuch as history may be interpreted as an accounting for any number of lives in the aggregate, we accept the two statements as at least roughly equivalent to one another. The point is, did Toynbee, who dedicated his own life to making sense of history, really believe either of these formulations? It is impossible to say. What we do know is that Toynbee, like all narrative historians, as opposed to historical statisticians, translated history into stories. This is to say, he endeavored to identify and select out of the restless stream of one damn thing after another only the very most important things. Yet this leaves us with another question. What is a historical thing? Is it an event? If so, what precisely constitutes an event? A sequence starting with causes and ending with effects? But how to identify the causes and how to judge the effects? In the end, the narratives we call history are fictions, and the very best histories, the most compelling and revelatory histories, are the most plausible fictions. We must not mistake even the best of these narratives for objective reality. So, is there a way of understanding the past that gets us beyond having to make up stories about things, events, causes, and effects? When we read a long, complex novel, Tolstoy's War and Peace, say, or see a richly plotted movie, David Lean's classic Lawrence of Arabia comes to mind, we can struggle to remember all the names, characters, and scenes and find ourselves missing the entire experience, coming away bored and exhausted instead of stimulated and enlightened. Or we can focus on what drives the story, which is called plot, and what propels the plot, which are any number of turning points. In history, as in a big novel or a big movie, what most compels us in the long run are not the things, events, and causes, but the turning points, the decisions, acts, innovations, errors, ideas, successes, and failures on which the contours of the nation's life, our lives, depend. Turning points create what we call destiny or direction. They spin off our values and ideals as well as our flaws, foibles, and faults. Turning points are like the peaks of an electrocardiogram, an EKG. They mark the very pulse of the nation's history. This book, then, does not claim to present American history, let alone the most important things, events, and causes in American history. Instead, it identifies 100 points at which the national path we share turned on its way to where we find ourselves more or less in the present. If you prefer, think of these turnings as fulcrums on which the levers of national belief, effort, and endeavor lift us or let us down. In either case, they are the features of our shared story that keep us glued to the narrative, that keep us from slamming the book cover shut or taking our popcorn and walking out of the theater. They are the points, the moments at which those who came before us could have gone this way or that, and so we are better off knowing about them and recalling them and thinking about them than remaining unaware of them, forgetting them, or ignoring them. Columbus arrives in the New World, 1492. Over the past three decades or more, a laudable evolution toward increased respect for human rights has created a growing backlash against Christopher Columbus, who, upon discovering America, tried to promote to his patrons, Spain's King Ferdinand and Queen Isabella, the enormous value of Native American slave labor. The Spanish monarchs had authorized Columbus's voyage on April 29, 1492.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.